Hi, this is Dr. Brian Ho. Welcome to Oakridge Orthodontics. Today I would like to share with you what's an ideal bite or what a perfect occlusion should look like. Now, if your upper and lower jaw are symmetrical and you got even number of teeth, when the upper and lower teeth come together, usually over all the upper teeth should have even contact with the bottom teeth, like this. Okay? Now, and the front teeth should be a little bit forward than the lower teeth, usually about 1 to 2 millimeters. At the back, the tipped upper teeth should fit nicely into the groove formed by the two adjacent lower teeth.
So you can see how well this upper teeth is fit into the groove formed by the two adjacent lower teeth. If you take a look at the front here, this upper teeth a little bit forward the lower teeth.
Now that's for our anatomy to find the maximum fit and therefore the most stable bite. And why do we really like this particular position? If you look at the anatomy of the teeth, the front teeth are pretty much very different than the back teeth. The front teeth are thinner, like knife edge, the back teeth are broader. So the front teeth are really designed like two blades of scissors, which crisscross a little bit and help cut the food. The back teeth with a broader surface is to help with the heavy grinding and chewing of the food. At this particular position, you can cut your food and grind your food without your jaw move forward or back too much. Therefore, it's the easiest for the muscle to work and the most relaxed for the joint. And that's exactly what our anatomy is designed to function. At Oakridge Orthodontics, when we correct the alignment of the teeth, that's always the goal that would bring our patient's teeth into this ideal bite. So the patient will have a nice, beautiful smile, but at the same time has a good functional bite. Now, if you have any question regarding to your bite or your smile, please do not hesitate to contact us.